My name is Maya, a sixth grader going to Dimmitt Middle School. I enjoy drawing, art, and anime. I speak half fluent Amharic house words like do your homework and get your booty off the couch. I read Korean only because of my Taekwondo and fluent English demonstrated by my exquisitely eloquent speech you will hear today. Today marks the day we say goodbye to the summer U and hello to the school U. I say goodbye to watching pirated movies on the laptop with my cousins in Ethiopia. Goodbye to staying up late, sleeping in, and forgetting if it's Monday or Thursday. I say goodbye to the beautifully designed lunch count board made by my fifth grade teacher at Campbell Hill, Miss Angel. The job board greeted me by the cabinets as well. I say hello to old friends in the halls and finding new ones. Hello to a new school, a new beginning. I say hello to being stressed out by my parents and teachers alike about my grades. When beginning a new school year, everything's familiar but not familiar at all. The new year is a time to look back, look forward, and to think about what are you going to do differently. Today, there are approximately 2,000 individuals who work hard to make schools a place that is welcoming. Not just teachers, but all sorts of school officials, like the bus driver that drove you here, custodians, security guards, paraprofessionals, cafeteria managers. After a long morning of math equations, the only thing that's on our mind is lunchtime. My favorite subject, that's when the cafeteria managers are our savior. When Ajane spills her chunky chocolate milk all over the table, the custodian is already on the job. When Marco wants a new carton of milk, he can raise his hand. A para will come right over giving you permission to snag some of that good calcium in a carton. And if Billy tries to snatch his milk, could we call security for that? Lastly, after a long afternoon of work, many of us need a ride home from the bus driver. And trust me, those are some of the best people to talk to when you've had a long and grueling day. Each and every one of you plays an important part in our lives. It's everyone's job here to work together to do their part in making schools a place students want to learn, especially the vegetables of the school, teachers. Teachers are like vegetables because not everyone likes them, but you need them to help you grow. Teachers have an important role, and just like Brussels sprouts, it takes skill and special personal touch to captivate students' minds. To be a good teacher, you must help students see themselves in your school. You do this by being someone who cares about their education and about what they think and feel. It's someone who is there for you and not just to work. Take time to build trust so you know how to support a student. If students don't see themselves at your school, they'll believe it's not the right place for them and shy away from their opportunities. If I may offer, I'd like to put forth a challenge to all of you. Challenge yourself to connect more. I'd like to share lessons I learned from my mother country, Ethiopia, in the summer. In Ethiopia, everyone was like family, and you didn't feel disconnect. Most don't have internet, meaning they're not relying on it, like me. Being online connects you to people you would have never met through texting, forums, etc., but it can also drive you away from the world around you. Here, you're distant from most everyone. I encourage you to break those walls. Being close to others can help you, understanding yourself and understanding others. By doing this, we all share a little more of ourselves and help each other grow towards being our best selves, or your star player, as I would call it. This upcoming year, I want you to think, what steps do you need to take to become your star player? Remember, the Renton School District motto is service, excellence, and equity. In order to do this, all students must feel connected. I hope all of you have a wonderful school year.